Okay, I had enough questions about the force vector problem, so I thought I'd do one. We have a situation where you have an object on a tilted surface, and for now I'll just say it's a kid on a roof. So you have the tilted surface, pen's running out of ink, I've already done this demonstration a couple times. A kid on a tilted roof that's afraid of falling off and breaking legs and doing something tragic to himself. The point on this line is just going to be the kid, just because I can't draw. You have three vectors affecting this kid. One is a weight vector. It's basically his own weight. Let's just pretend for giggles that he weighs 100 pounds. You have the force actually that he's applying to the roof to keep himself from sliding off. So we'll call that, actually I'm going to put this above, we'll call that F. And then there's a normal force that the roof is applying to him, and that's basically the roof pushing up, just like the earth pushes up on you. A roof will push up on you as well. And if you notice, the normal and the force vectors are both perpendicular to each other, so I'm going to draw a 90-degree angle there. I also have to give you one other piece of information. Let's pretend, for argument's sake, this roof is pitched at 30 degrees, which is a pretty steep roof. So maybe you live in Switzerland or something like that. All right, so I have these three vectors. You know that, and as we discussed in class, you know that the sum of these vectors have to add up to zero. Reason why is if they don't, one of the vectors starts to win. In other words, the kid falls through the roof, or he starts to push himself up, or the roof shoots him off into the air. None of that of which we want in this situation. We want static equilibrium, so we want the normal vector plus the force vector plus that weight vector to all add up to zero. Graphically, that means if I were to draw these from tail to head addition, which I will in a moment, they should add up from the start, they should add up to get all the way back to that start. The ending will be the start. So I'm going to take any one of these vectors, but I'll give you a hint here. You usually want to grab one of the two that are perpendicular to each other. I'll grab the normal vector here. When I draw this, here's a big deal. Well, of course, I just didn't do it, but when I draw it, I want to draw it the same angle, or try to, just make it look like it's the same angle, like it is on that force drawing. So there we are, that's the normal vector. And then I'm going to pick up the force vector that I've drawn here, and I'm just going to paste it. Just think like your Microsoft Office or something like that. You're going to copy and paste. That's all you're doing. Notice I try to keep the same angle here. You know this is a 90-degree angle between the force vector and the normal vector. And finally, you want to draw the weight vector. Now, I've done these problems for a long time, so I have a habit of drawing them correctly the first time. Let's pretend that when I first drew this normal vector, I drew it a little short. And you say, okay, well, now my teacher said the weight vector pushes down. Oh no, look, they don't meet up. What do you think you're going to do? Well, you're not going to answer me because you're at a different time. However, what you should do is realize that you don't know the length of this normal vector, nor do you know the length of this force vector. You can adjust their lengths as much as you want. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and adjust the length of the normal vector to meet up with my weight vector, just to make the picture work. All right. One other thing we need in here. So we have a right triangle, and we have the normal, the force, and the weight all there. I know the length of the side. I would like to have an angle, one other angle in here. Once I have all those situations met, I will then have the system solved. Here's my horizontal. I'm going to go ahead and draw another one right here. These two angles, and I have to get in a position where you can see what I'm doing, these two angles right here have to be the same. This is a horizontal line, this is a horizontal line. Here's a line cutting through, so it's a bisector. Not a bisector, but transverse, whatever you want to call it. This is 30 degrees. Somebody's going to email me and say, that's not what you call it. Anyway, this is 30 degrees. So if this angle is 30 degrees, I could use that. Now, don't just think, oh, the angle between F and something is 30 degrees. That's not true, because you don't have anything. This is just F. You don't have anything else between F and anything. Like, you don't have another vector there. So I would like to find the angle between F and W. I'm just going to pick up this W. Pick up this W and place it at the end of F here. I'm This is a 90 degree angle. See, this is 30, this is 90. This angle between F and W must be 60. That's probably where most of you are going to get lost. So now I have a right triangle. Some people really like to redraw this so it's not so ugly. I agree. Here's my right triangle. This length right here is 100. This angle right here is 60. This length right here is the length of the normal vector. And this length is the length of the force vector. From here, you can use sine, cosine to get the resulting lengths. So that's your hint on those set of problems.